Our original band was started in 1944. Three Streeter brothers, 11 years old, 13, and 15. So we had to be kind of careful where we played, and you know. But it turned out after 5 years since then, we've 1949 we started the Adirondack Playboys band, which got us bigger and better. We added another member to the band, and we just stretched out more and got more dates to play, and it turned out really well for us.
My name's Rick Streeter. I'm from New Bremen, which is a couple miles from here. I've been playing since the late 60s, early 70s, and I play mandolin and fiddle.
I'm Shelley. I live just across the way, over there in the other street in Krogan. I've been with the band for over 10 years since my dad passed away, but I've been playing bass guitar since probably fourth grade. I learned some notes.
I'm J.C. Moore. I live in Harrisville, which is like 20 miles away, and been playing drums all my life, different bands. They needed a drummer like 3 years ago or so, on and off. I'd fill in. I filled in before that a few times, way back.
Yeah.
But I wasn't playing in bands, and as they're a great bunch of people, so I couldn't.
Thank you, Jay.
They are. Well, you know. So anyway, it's a great job, and it's fun. It's a lot of fun to play with people you really enjoy playing with. That's the whole main time. That's my story.
You sticking to it?
I'm going to stick to it.
My turn?
Okay. I'm Dale. I play the rhythm guitar in the band and do most of the vocals. Rick does some. We got to give him credit there. He does a good job. I live out of Governor toward Black Lake in St. Lawrence County. And I've been playing in the band a little less than Rick, probably the very early 1970s. I actually joined the band, we moved from rhythm guitar to bass guitar to back to rhythm guitar, and that's what I do. And I call most of the square dancing too.
I'm Cliff Streeter. I play the pedal steel guitar. I'm the last of the original Adirondack Playboys band, and I enjoy these guys because they help me out a lot. I'm from this area, Krogan, New York.
It's a fun time. So, name is Bob. And I'm 80 years old.
Are you a big country music fan?
I wasn't until I met her.
Yeah. I converted him.
Yeah, she converted me. So, yeah, I like bluegrass, blues.
Let's see what it sounds like.
Country.
I'd like to be in Charlie's shoes. That's what I always said. He had you and everything. Tied to the golden thread. Then Charlie left and went to the wind. When I got the news, it wasn't long.
Community that follows these guys, it's neat. I've never had, I joked about it. I said I've never been in a band that had a following, you know, and it's true. And but they'll shuffle by and they'll be dancing, they'll be waving at you, and I'm playing them, you know. But it's pretty neat. People do that, and then Christmas time, or they'll give you little gifts. I got a nice keychain I'm using now, little oddball things that they just
chocolate Easter bunny.
Yeah, they give you stuff. They'll just give us little gifts, and it's. Like I say, it's quite a community.
We have continued to stay true to the style of music that we play, and all age groups still enjoy it. And the younger generation, you know, little Owen who plays the fiddle and is learning and all that, everybody's enjoying this kind of music, and in some respects there's a little bit of a resurgence in traditional roots-type country music. And last week at our dance, we had a dance last week, and there's one lady that comes, and she would always dance in front of the where we're performing, and if I was really serious, she would smile, Dale. So every time she dances by me now for a long time, I just go with a big smile. She took a picture of me. I didn't even know. And she put the picture on a smiley face balloon, helium balloon, and I had to hang that in front of the performance last week.
You missed that.
So we had to live with two Dales.
Yeah, that's pretty tough. Was he my other brother, Dale?
Yeah.
Crazy.
A year and a half ago, I threatened to quit the band. Mm-hmm. I said threatened. But I wanted to quit the band because I was getting older. But these guys made me an offer I couldn't refuse. Said, we'll pick up your stuff, take you with us, bring home your stuff. Hey, you can't refuse that. So that's why I'm still with the band today. Yeah.
Heavy stuff too, isn't it, Rick?
Yes, it is.
Yep. We'll throw it around for you though, Cliff. We don't mind a bit.
You can get a heavier one if you want. We'll still do it.
My stuff is heavy, and I'll tell you, glad these guys are around. They really help me, and I appreciate that. Our mother played the piano and fiddle when we were growing up. I think that inspired us to start the band. And, you know, it's you look back and you just wonder, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You think that's really what started it, so we're happy about that.
Yeah.
Well, Cliff, when you guys were young, first starting to play out, Didn't Grandpa used to take you in the back of the truck? Is how he got you to places? Yeah.
That's what I wanted to hear him talk about.
We had a pickup truck. I was born and brought up in a dairy farm. We only had a pickup truck for getting around. And we would go in the back of the truck, even winter or summer, no matter what. And we had a big horse blanket there to keep us warm. And we would go to these dances, and they would take us. And you look back, and you just wonder how you survived, really, you know.
Someone was telling me that it was all the Streeter brothers had to sit in the back of the truck because of the instruments.
I want to mention, we were all self-taught. Didn't take any lessons on anything. We just picked up an instrument and started learning to play it. And can't read any music. People wonder, how come you can play, you can't read music? Well, we play by ear. Well, today, country music isn't country music. Mm-hmm. You watch the award show on TV, and it's gone completely the other way, and nothing wrong with it, but country music to me is country music. It's not something else. And that, you know, I just, it has changed a lot.
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's good stuff.
We can already tell. I'm going to take my horse on the old town road. I'm going to run into the deep drop. I'm going to take my horse on the old town road. Here it is.
I think it's a mix of everything.
Sounds more like Homer and Jethro or something from the 60s, you know, did parodies.
Change of clothes now, and then Walmart. And this is, I like that band, so now we bring up the
takes 8 D batteries.
I guess I asked her to dance.
Wow.
Oh, that's a waltz.
Yeah?
We didn't know that, but we just danced. And that's always been our song. That was in 1981 or 82. We didn't start dating until 84.
That was 82.
And that was a long time ago. So every time, you know, they play that song, you know, we usually have to get up and dance. But she doesn't like the waltz because she has trouble counting to three, but she's a good cook.
Okay.
Don't bother you.
Yeah.
Oh, now the first couple promenade outside in the moonlight, round outside. Kiss my friends and send her a six-hand round. Now kiss your little darling if you will. Get to the side, you're on the corner with your partner on the corner. Your grand rights and love on the way around. Get your little side on the corner with your partner on the corner. Grand rights and love all the way around.
Yeah, I think that this whole band, you know, I never really envisioned playing country music. When we were teenagers, we wanted to play rock and roll and all that stuff. But you learn as you grow older to appreciate things that your relatives have done. And the original band, it's amazing that they have had the followings they've had up until the time that even we joined, it just continued. And you ask people around here, well, you know about those Adirondack Playboys. Oh, you mean the Streeter Boys, you know, or something like that. And, you know, heck, I remember going to Grange Hall every Saturday night. And people come up with all these stories and everything because you guys were a fixture in this area for playing music. And we're just continuing it, which is amazing.
And we attended everything even when we were little.
Oh, yeah.
Right from when we were old enough to go.
It's been quite a ride with the band here. I would love to be able to say I could play until I can't. Mm-hmm. I probably will.
I can't.
Yeah,
say that.
We all will.
Yeah, because you're going to retire and you're going to travel and. So then, what are we supposed to do? Am I supposed to go back to the base, or is McKenna going to stay in town, or is she going to move away? You know, so.
I got some fishing to do.
McKenna's got a whole lot of interest. McKenna's got.
She's
going to
go to college, and she
writes. I'd like to sit down and write.